Okay, now the next question is, what is our pound for pound list? And that question is coming from Leroy G in Philly. So Leroy, we're about to tell you what our pound for pound is, but first we're going to tell you why or who makes our pound for pound and why they make it. Our pound for pound list is composed of active fighters who openly seek the challenge of fighting the best in their division and taking on all opponents and disposing them of such a great manner. That's who we consist and who we use as our pound for pound fighters. Our pound for pound list does not coincide with anybody's out there that you're going to read. As a matter of fact, a lot of people would say that we're done for our pound for pound list, but so be it. We know what we know, and that's what we think should be on there.
Definitely. Let's go ahead and start at number 10.
At number 10, we got Israel Vasquez. Your thoughts?
Israel Vasquez, a very young, talented fighter. Just defeated Rafael Marquez in his last fight, and that's why he made the cut on the top 10 list. He's been dominating at 122. And just dominated, or not completely dominated, but defeated the guy who beat him last and the guy who's been dominated at 118. So that's why he made number 10.
The best thing about this guy is the fact that now there's going to be a part 3 of this trilogy, and we'll get to see another great fight at that weight class and show why him or Marquez can be in the pound for pound list next time they fight. At number 9, we got Ronald Winky Wright.
Ronald Winky Wright. I think he's a great fighter. He's got a lot of skill, a lot of talent, but he's... What, 1-1-1 in his last couple of fights? Why are you laughing, man?
I disagree. Winky Ronald White, you're garbage. You shouldn't be on this sorry-ass fucking list. Fucking he put you on this shit, not me. You are garbage, complete garbage. I wouldn't put you on here. The last 3 fights you fought, Jermaine Taylor got a draw. I Corte, who hasn't done nothing in Lord knows how many years, you beat him. What did he do for you? And then who else?
Bernard Hopkins.
Bernard Hopkins, you lost. So, no, a draw, a loss, and a win. And the win came against somebody who's not even a top challenger anymore.
Hey, but
so,
I say he's got skills. Like, he's very crafty.
He can have skills, but again, our pound for pound is who has won with recently. He has not. Well, you have not done nothing recently. That's why you're number 9. We're moving on. At number 8, Ricky Hatton.
Ricky Hatton, what can you say about Ricky Hatton? He's about to take the number 1 pound for pound guy. I think he's very talented. He's got his own style of fighting. I think because of that style, he's gotten this far. And we'll see how far I can take him in his next couple fights.
Ricky Hatton, I think he's a good kid. He does the, you know, good pressure, always on you, always attacking, ready to fight. It's going to be an interesting fight when he fights Mayweather. Like I said, he's got everything to gain and nothing to lose in that fight. So either way, it's a win-win situation for Ricky Hatton. I predict him to be in this pound for pound list for a couple more years. He does his job and he does it well. At number 7, we got Miguel Cotto.
Miguel Cotto, what can I say about Miguel Cotto? I'll tell you what I can say about him. He's probably one of the most underrated fighters today at this point in time. Everybody wants to talk about him being weak chin, but I tell you what he does with relentless power and veracity that most guys can't handle. He's defeated very talented individuals, even starting from, we could say, as early as his career. As his 10th fight, he's fought Justin Jucco. Not too many people know about Justin Jucco out there, but Justin Jucco was a veteran at the time on his 10th fight, and he soundly defeated him by the 5th round. He TKO'd him, and I'll tell you one thing, the number 1 pound-for-pound guy only took him out in a decision fight after 12 rounds. So
Miguel,
look out for Miguel Cotto.
Miguel Cotto, definitely number 7 pick. I think he's good at that position. He's beat up all the people that have been put in front of him the past fights, Zab Judah, Malinagi, Pinto, Juco, like he said. There's many Victor Llano Sosa. There's a lot of people. Good spot for Miguel Cotto. And number 6, we got Juan Manuel Marquez.
Juan Manuel Marquez, the brother of Rafael Marquez, dominating a lot of different individuals there. The reason why I put him actually on number 6, he thinks it should be a little bit higher.
I believe he should be higher.
But I put him at number 6 because he does have a loss to Chris John, and having a loss brings you down. Just like it did Winky Wright, it did the same thing to Marquez.
Well, I believe Marquez will be back on top where he belongs once he beats up Pacquiao in 2008. He will beat Pacquiao. Remember where you heard it first. I'm predicting it now. He should have. Telling y'all, it's going to happen. At number 5, I don't agree with this pick. He should be higher up in the list, but again, he's holding me back, won't let me put him any higher. This pick belongs at number 5 is Joe Calzaghe. Joe Calzaghe has been a devastating force at 168. He's been a dominant champ for over 10 years. He's beat up all the bums that have been placed in front of him, and he's called out all the great champs who nobody wants to fight him. This dude got power, he got combination, and he's got boxing skills.
Well, I think he said it at all, but he also said one thing, that the reason why he's not any higher is because he's fighting bums. And it's not his fault that he's that talented in the division who's lacking talent. But because of that, I'm sorry, you're going to be your own victim in your own weight division. Either move up or move down. Do what you got to do and continue fighting. But you are a good champion. You've been a champion for over 10 years, and that's that. That's why you only fall to number 5.
No, that's why we're putting him at 4A. And then actually the 4B is Manny Pacquiao.
Manny Pacquiao, man, that's a devastating puncher. I love this kid's style. He's relentless. He's one-dimensional. That's what they like to say. But what a dimension, I tell you that right now. That dimension is destroying everybody. He's going to go up against Barrera next, and hopefully he'll go ahead and destroy Marquez, which I believe will destroy Marquez in their rematch. Even though it was a draw, I think he'll take him out the next
round. Not happening. Barrera, Manny Pacquiao, you better watch out for Barrera. I think you're going to beat him. But watch out in 08 for Marquez, who's coming to hunt you down. He's going to win. At number 3, we got Mr. Bernard Hopkins, B-Hop, the Executioner. What you got to say about that?
A relentless guy as well. A guy who's a throwback to boxing. I think he should belong back in the early ages. He would have been fared well. I think he would have fared well, and he's faring very well. He's probably one of the great fighters here today in this era. And definitely Bernard Hopkins, he just keeps winning. What can you say about this guy? With the exception of Jermaine Taylor twice, 2 decisions that were disputed. Controversial decisions, but other than that, he's been winning, and that's the main thing to be in the top count.
I believe Bernard Hopkins is probably the most craftiest boxer in boxing right now. He's always in shape, can fight, street fight, can box, can do anything you need him to do. He finds always a way to win. He might not be the most impressive doing it, but he gets the job done. That's why he's at number 3. At number 2, we've got probably the most underrated boxer of all of them, Jermaine Taylor.
This is probably one of the most decorated guys, you could say, from the class of 2000 Olympians, defeated Bernard Hopkins twice, whether it's disputed or not. It's a win in the record books, and that's all that matters. And to be the man, you have to beat the man, and he beat the man twice.
And right now, he is the man at 160, so until otherwise, y'all have to beat him, and he then will come down. Until then, he's at number 2. And number 1, we've got the pound-for-pound Picasso.
The Prince of Pugilism, that's all it is. It's Floyd Mayweather Jr. How can you dispute that? He's undisputed at this point in time.
He's got all the tools to win. He does everything he needs to do to win. He's had the great career from 130 all the way to 154 when he fought Oscar De La Hoya. So until somebody beats the man, he is the man. And that's our top for 10, pound for pound. Again, in order is Israel Vasquez at number 10. At number 9, Winky Wright. At number 8, Ricky Hatton. At 7, Miguel Cotto. At 6, Marquez. At 5, Manny Pacquiao. At 4, Joe Calzaghe. At 3, Bernard Hopkins. At 2, Jermaine Taylor. And at number 1, Floyd Mayweather Jr.
You're mad, 35. That's all I can say.
Floyd Mayweather. Anyways, and that's our top 10. If you have any questions about it, or if you have any other questions that you would like about boxing answered by us, let us know. We are more than happy to answer any questions you guys got. P4PMail@yahoo.com. If you don't know how to spell that, look at the bottom of the screen. It's going to be up. Hit us with comments. Hit us with emails, hit us with subscriptions. The more we see you guys subscribing, let us know that you guys like what we do, and we'll keep doing it. If not, then we'll stop. Y'all can look at the rest of the people on YouTube.
You can enjoy those.
You can enjoy them. But again, hit us up, people@yahoo.com.
Thank you for watching. Appreciate it.
And this is Pound for Pound Boxing, where we hold back no punches. Julio Volte, yo, dime, Cypher Lex, oye, yeah. Ese pito, salió Julio Volte, ay bendito, tienen que respetarme todos estos chamaquitos, de los bobos y los pendejos nace Cristo, y se rapan pa' carajo nada más de escucharle el pito, cante como Caliente, God damn, I love boxing, y los achoco como Tito, que igualito, que Condorito.